We are here with George Sauder. And George, you are the president of Sauder Engineering Corporation?
That's right.
And can you give me a little idea of what Sauder Engineering Corporation does?
Well, we're specialists in prevention of slip and fall accidents.
Okay.
And I'm a registered professional engineer in the state of California, and I'm certified by the city of Los Angeles for testing slip resistance of floors. Oh. And a consultant to some cruise ship companies and building contractors, attorneys. Mm-hmm. I'm an expert witness in slip and fall accidents for both the plaintiff and defendant.
Ah, okay.
And have testified in court a number mm-hmm. of times, investigated hundreds of cases, and we sell instruments for measuring slip resistance of floors, and we do testing for property owners and all sorts of people.
Okay, wonderful. So you do the research side as well as the defending side of the whole slip fall industry.
That's right.
And it's anything from, like you said, cruise ships to commercial buildings.
That's right.
And everything in between. Okay, now George, you are going to be giving a presentation on slip fall liability at the Global Leadership Summit here for Concrete Polishing University. Can you just give me a little overview as to what you'll be talking about today?
Sure. Well, I'm attracted to the polishing concrete industry at this stage in its development because they're just starting to be affected mm-hmm. by requirements for slip and fall mm-hmm. prevention.
Okay.
And what they're going to need is some help getting started, and then after that they're going to be able to carry on their own. Mm. Now, a lot of work has been done in Australia in previous years on slip and fall prevention on polished concrete because the Australians took a cue from the Germans, who had the world's most sophisticated slip and fall prevention regulations, mm-hmm. and the Australians improved on them, and now they've had a number of years, about 20 years or so, of actually using those standards. And they have different standards for different types of areas, like an upstairs elevator lobby might not require any wet slip resistance because it's going to be dry all the time. Mm-hmm. But a downstairs lobby in a hotel, for instance, might be getting wet when it's raining outside, and so it has to have good slip resistance. And so, of course, an outdoor surface must have excellent slip resistance, and even when people are running.
Right.
And people are conditioned to feel that they can run outdoors, mm-hmm. and they will. And so it's a more demanding situation there.
Understandable. So you've been collecting this data. You've been working with companies that have been collecting this data over in Australia for the past 20 years, and you're going to help relay that information today at our Global Leadership
Summit. That's right. I keep in touch with slip and fall developments worldwide, mm-hmm.